Hello friends, welcome to UPSC Logics and my name is Siddharth and today I am going to cover the Indian history and the role of Gandhi. So this is the part 1 of the series and we are going to cover it in one line of format. So these are over 100 questions that are related to Gandhiji's initial struggle from 1915 to 1931. So let us begin this video. So Gandhiji returned from South Africa and landed in Bombay on January 9, 1915 and we know that he was working as a lawyer in South Africa and was fighting for the rights of the South African Indians. And on his return, Gandhiji stayed at Patit Jahangir's house in Santa Cruz. So Gandhiji changed his attire to a Swadeshi dress as soon as he touched the Indian soil, which was a Kathiyawadi cloak, turban and dhoti. He was advised to remain an observer and student in the country for a year before taking part in Indian politics by Annie Besant. And soon after he reached Bombay, Gandhiji went to Pune to meet the founders of Servants of India Society, who was Gopal Krishna Gokhale. So Gandhiji kept a 1 year silence and this was ended with the opening ceremony of Banaras Hindu University, where he spoke on February 4, 1916. Gandhiji's attention was drawn towards the hardships inflicted on the people of Virgram because of the notorious custom cordon, and for the removal of which Gandhiji hinted at a possibility of satyagraha. So his attention was drawn to this particular problem by Motilal Nehru, and the first problems that Gandhiji took was the abolition of the indentured labor. And the problem had been in India since the abolition of slavery since 1833. Then he took his first task and began a series of lectures in Bombay. So the last date of abolition of indentured labor was fixed by the Imperial Citizenship Association on 31st July 1917. But they did not actually remove the or abolish the indentured labor. So there was a public agitation and there was a preparedness of satyagraha or for satyagraha that forced the government to abolish the indentured system altogether, and this was done on January 1, 1920. So Gandhiji's first major struggle was in connection with Champaran satyagraha in 1917, and it was Rajkumar Shukla who actually drew Gandhiji's attention towards the indigo plantations. And Gandhiji left for Champaran to see the problems of indigo cultivators firsthand in April 1917. So the indigo planters were forced to grow indigo on 3/20th percent of their lands. And the local interpreters that helped Gandhiji were Dharinder and Ram Narayan Prasad. So a case was registered against Gandhiji and Gandhiji thought that he might have to go to jail. So he chose Brij Kumar Prasad and Mazrul Haq to lead the Champaran agitation. C.F. Andrews acted as a contact man between Gandhiji and Sir Edward Gate, who was the Lieutenant Governor of Bengal, and this resulted in an unconditional withdrawal of the case against Gandhiji, thus enabling him to pursue the work in Champaran. So Gandhiji examined around 4,000 peasants and this became the basis of the famous survey of Champaran struggle. And a Champaran Inquiry Committee was appointed by the Governor of Bihar and Orissa on June 13, 1917. And Gandhiji was successful in getting appointed as himself as one of the members of the committee. And this committee was required to submit its report within 3 months. So the Champaran Agrarian Bill was introduced on November 29, 1917 and was introduced by W. Manda. And despite the demands of Champaran being met, Gandhiji considered his work to be unfinished and opened schools in Champaran, and the first school came up in Barharwa. Now after Champaran, Gandhiji's attention was drawn to Ahmedabad mill worker strike in February 1918 by Anusuya Ben. So there was a problem going on with the mill workers in Ahmedabad. And they had gone on a strike that lasted from February 22, 1918 and had continued till March 18. So this particular matter was referred to arbitration, and this arbitration was under Anand Shankar Dhruv, and Gandhiji, Shankarlal Banker and Vallabhbhai Patel acted on behalf of the workers, and the workers had been demanding a pay rise of 50% that was settled at 35%. So this particular strike lasted for around 21 days. And immediately after that, Gandhiji was rushed to Kheda. So there was already a prior inquiry in the matter done by Amritlal Thakkar, G.K. Devdar and N.M. Joshi. And the problem in Kheda was the suspension of land revenue assessment, as there had been a widespread failure of crops. So the claimed output of crops for that year had been less than 25%. So Gandhiji visited over 50 villages and made his suggestion to the government for half suspension of the land revenue. In the meantime, Vallabhbhai Patel also left his growing practice as a lawyer and joined Gandhiji in the Kheda district. Vittalbhai Patel and G.K. Parikh started an agitation in the Bombay Legislative Council in connection with the Kheda struggle. So the Kheda struggle or the Kheda Satyagraha started in the real earnest on 22nd March 1918, and Mohanlal Pandya, who would go to the lands of the farmers and steal the crops before the British could confiscate them, was honored with the title of Onion Thief. So this particular struggle lasted for almost 4 months, and Gandhiji also started the no tax campaign and the recruitment for the British in their war efforts from Kheda. So when in 1919 the Montague James Ford reforms that were launched in July 1918, Gandhiji had said the scheme deserves sympathetic consideration rather than a summary rejection. And after he had read the recommendations of the Rowlatt Act, he had first mentioned about his apprehensions to Vallabhbhai Patel. So to organize a resistance against the Rowlatt Act, Gandhiji decided to launch a satyagraha from Sabarmati Ashram, and this pledge was signed on 24th of February 1919, and there were 24 people who were present to sign this particular pledge. So the Rowlatt satyagraha started in Bombay. Rowlatt Bill No. 2 was published as an act, and Gandhiji came up with an idea of a hartal, and he told this plan of organizing a hartal to C. Rajgopalachari. So there was a hartal called in March 1919, and a huge procession was taken out in Chandni Chowk, and people faced the atrocities of the British bare-chested, whose leader was Swami Shraddhanand. So Gandhiji wrote a few works in regards to the Rowlatt agitation, and these were in Hind Swaraj, Sarvodaya and the Story of a Satyagrahi. So Gandhiji left for Punjab on 8th of April 1919, but was forced off a train and was taken to Bombay, where he was set free. So he was disembarked at a station called Palwal. So the place where Gandhiji coined the phrase Himalayan miscalculation was Nadiad. And the Himalayan miscalculation was that the peaceful satyagraha that he had launched in connection with the Rowlatt satyagraha had turned violent. So Gandhiji regarded the 1919 Congress session as his real entry into Congress politics, and this session was held at Amritsar. So Gandhiji had attended the first session of the Congress in 1901, although Gandhiji had joined Congress, or the real entry of Gandhiji into Congress politics was in 1919. So to defy the government orders, Gandhiji published an unregistered weekly called Satyagraha in 1919. And Gandhiji wasn't allowed to enter Punjab after the Jallianwala Bagh massacre, and was only allowed there after October 1919. So the Indian National Congress set up a separate committee to look into the atrocities of the Punjab, and the report of which was prepared by Gandhiji and submitted in March 1920. So Gandhiji considered the Khilafat movement as a golden opportunity for the Hindu-Muslim unity, and this issue was related towards the policy of Britain towards Turkey, and Gandhiji was elected the president of All Khilafat India movement in November 1919. At Delhi. So prior to Gandhi's entry into the Congress, there were no rules and just guidelines that had been framed by Gopal Krishna Gokhale, and Gandhiji drafted the constitution of the Congress with the help of N.C. Kelkar and I.B. Sen. So the final draft of the Congress, which defined the goals of the Congress as Swaraj with or without the British government, was adopted at the Nagpur session. Before launching any movement, Gandhiji launched a campaign to enlist a crore of members in the Congress in April 1921, and all these were a part of the non-cooperation movement that Gandhiji had launched. So the amount raised for the Tilak Swaraj Fund was at 1 crores. And to launch a national constructive program, Gandhiji launched 20 lakh charkhas as part of the program. So the non-cooperation movement was launched with the surrender of all titles given by the British to Gandhiji on 1st of August 1920. And this was also the date on which the Khilafat movement had decided to launch the non-cooperation movement. But the non-cooperation movement in true earnest started from 1st of January 1921. Then the special session of the Congress was organized to accept Gandhiji's proposal of the non-cooperation movement and to redress the Khilafat wrong was in September in Calcutta in 1920. So who were the leaders that advocated the demand for Swaraj should be included with the demands of non-cooperation movement, to which Gandhiji had agreed and resolution was passed by the Congress in 1920 at the annual session at Nagpur, and this was Motilal Nehru and C. Vigrahachari. So these were the two leaders who said that besides the three demands, which were remedifying the Jallianwala Bagh massacre, the Rowlatt Act and the Khilafat movement, Swaraj should be added as a fourth or the third demand for the non-cooperation movement. And Gandhiji's proposal to boycott the legislative councils was strongly opposed by one of the leaders, and he was C.R. Das. So Gandhiji made an observation that if people followed his program, Swaraj could be achieved within a year, and this was in 1920. So Bardoli was the place from where he decided to launch the civil disobedience movement, and before the civil disobedience movement could be effectively launched, there was a mob violence in Chauri Chaura in Uttar Pradesh. So the program of the civil disobedience was suspended by Gandhiji, and this was replaced by a constructive program on 12th of February 1922 at Bardoli. So many leaders did not like this idea of Gandhiji suspending the civil disobedience movement, and one of the leaders who wrote to Gandhiji strongly in this regard was Motilal Nehru. Subhash Chandra Bose called the dropping of the civil disobedience movement as a national calamity. Now, Gandhiji was arrested for the first time for sedition in Ahmedabad, and this was for writing an article in the magazine Young India that were tampering with loyalty, the puzzle and its solution, and shaking the mains. So there were two lawyers who had roaring practice like Motilal Nehru and C.R. Das, who had left these practices to join Gandhiji. And Gandhiji had decided to use the time from 1924 to 28 for his constructive program that included 13 programs. So Gandhiji basically found himself or called himself defeated and humbled in the Congress session that was held in June 1924. And this was because of a violence that had broken out in Kohat. And he had taken up a fast of 21 days at the residence of Muhammad Ali, and this was a Hindu-Muslim riot. So Gandhiji presided over the Belgaum session in December 1924 on the persistence of C.R. Das, and the Gandhi-Nehru-Das pact altered the Congress franchise and made the spinning a qualification rather than four anas a year. So these four anas were basically the fees for the Congress membership, and instead they said that spinning the wheel was more of a qualification than just paying four anas a year as a member of the Congress. So the Kanpur session was held in December 1925 by Gandhiji, and this was in honor of Sarojini Naidu, who was the first woman president of the Congress. Now Gandhiji at the Congress session of Calcutta in 1929 suggested or moved the resolution in complete of complete independence in case dominion status was not granted by the end of 1929. It was in the Lahore session that Congress decided that the term Swaraj was to be considered as Poorn Swaraj, and the president was Jawaharlal Nehru in 1929. So a foreign cloth boycott committee was set up by the Congress on February 15, 1929. And a foreign cloth burning demonstration took place on March 4th, 1929 at Shraddhanand Park, Calcutta to demonstrate to the people the essentials or why it was important to boycott the foreign cloth. Now Gandhiji embarked on the famous Dandi March on 12th of March 1930 and he was accompanied by 78 people. Monday was kept as a day of rest. It took 24 days to complete this journey. It was 241 miles and Gandhiji was 61 years of age. So friends, most of us would be retiring at the age of 60 and Gandhiji was embarking on a 241 mile journey that took him 24 days to complete something for the nation. So friends, we can understand that how important it was for Gandhiji to work towards the betterment of the nation, and the independence of nation was so important to the leaders of the country. And in today's time, when we look back, it seems like a Herculean task to even imagine that how much sacrifice was made by our leaders to get us our independence. Now, in case Gandhiji was arrested, he nominated Vitthalbhai Patel to lead the Dandi March. Gandhiji was arrested in violation of the Salt Act on April 20, 1930. Jawaharlal Nehru was also arrested and he was arrested on April 14, 1930. And Gandhiji's arrest took an ugly turn when people took over the town, and this place was Surat. On 15th March 1931, negotiations began between Lord Irwin and Gandhiji, and Gandhiji kept 6 demands in front of Lord Irwin as an absolute minimum for negotiations. So the Gandhi-Irwin Pact was signed on March 5th, 1931. So friends, this brings us to the end of part 1 of this particular video, and I hope you have enjoyed this video. In case you have enjoyed this video, do like and subscribe to the channel. And don't forget to press the bell icon for the latest notifications from UPSC Logics. So in the next video, we shall continue from the part where Gandhiji was negotiating with Lord Irwin. So thank you so much for watching, and Jai Hind.